Queensland recorded an alarming 39 COVID-related deaths today. But the Chief Health Officer says, while tragic, the numbers don't reflect a rise after cases dating back a month were added to the tally. More than half were in aged care, where 229 Queenslanders have now lost their lives during this pandemic.
Dr. John Gerard has an unenviable daily duty to report the COVID numbers.
It's without doubt the most difficult part of this job. It is, however, critically important, I believe, that Queenslanders have a full understanding of the picture associated with this pandemic.
An image in sharp focus as 39 deaths were added to the 438 lives lost in Queensland. But while 12 were in the last 24 hours, another 27 trickled through from the Department of Births, Deaths and Marriages in a weekly report.
It is still just as devastating reporting these 39 deaths today as it would be if they had occurred in the last 24 hours.
21 more families grieving relatives who were in aged care. Just two had been given booster shots as federal rollout plans continue to face scrutiny.
They have dropped the ball all the way through, and COVID has just shone a light on that.
Numerous aged care homes are still going in and out of isolated lockdowns in an effort to control outbreaks. Investigations into reports of non-compliance by operators are ongoing. The Health Minister says a national audit of the sector is what's needed.
But what we do know is that they are not adequately paid. We do know that they don't have proper ratios in place.
There was more clarity today in relation to the cost of the Wellcamp quarantine hub. The Premier's bluff was called after she hinted at yesterday's opening that if the federal spend on the Pinkenba facility were to be released, so too would the state money contributed to the Toowoomba construction.
She cracked under pressure. She cracked under pressure from journalists.
For months, we were told it was commercial in confidence. Now we know $48.8 million was spent on construction. But as to the leasing agreement, expected to be more than $190 million in the first year, that same old catchphrase was wheeled out again.
We've released the capital cost, and of course, leasing remains commercial in confidence.
The opposition wants all details on the table, referring the project and an apparent lack of a tender process to the Auditor General.
We want to know every dollar that this is costing the Queensland taxpayer.
Chris Campy for 10 News First.